Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, and I'm going to be recording some standard with an all-in Aetherworks Marvel deck that, I don't remember exactly his name, but Patrick Sullivan's teammate played it at the SCG in Baltimore and did pretty well, I heard. At least that's what P. Sully told me. And he said he thinks this deck might be broken. It's all-in Aetherworks Marvel with sort of a controlling slant. It has three Fumigates in the main deck. And then a bunch of other removal, four Harness Lightning, four Aether Meltdown. So that should really help against something like vehicles. You can deal with their flying vehicles, you can deal with their blockers, and then fumigate them out. And then, of course, you're ultimately either ramping to or marveling into Ulamog, which is a pretty powerful endgame that not a lot of decks can deal with. So yeah, the deck is pretty much set up around that. The only oddball card sort of is Anticipate, but you're playing a combo deck, it makes sense to have a way to dig. And then post board you have the Tireless Tracker plan that has become so popular, as well as Authority for the Saheeli matchup, because you don't actually have a lot of cards that interact with that in game one. Linvala, just for sort of beatdown decks, and green black when you want to go a little bigger. Tracker again for when people are going to be hating on your Marvel. Dynavolt Tower for sort of the same reason, although it is vulnerable to a lot of the same hate as Marvel. It's just an additional way to use energy that is very good in games that go long. Then you have four Negate for control matchups, and Kozilek's Return for aggro decks. So let's get to some game. Alright, here we are for round one. We get to go first. This hand is mediocre, but I think it's a keep. We have a decent amount of energy, anticipate to hopefully dig us to something good. Yeah, I'll give it a whirl. So I think we will attune for, I guess, another Plains. We have plenty of sources of, we have double green, which is enough to play and activate Puzzle Knot in a turn. So yeah, double white is really the only thing we're likely to need. We have lots of blue sources, so we're fine on that front. I guess we can't cast two Harness Lightnings now if we somehow end up with two in our hand, but it seems less likely than just drawing a single Fumigate. Ooh, right on time with that one. Looks like we're probably up against some kind of Saheeli deck. Oh no, some kind of Heart of Kieran deck. Well, we can just melt down that now. Uses our mana pretty efficiently. That's excellent. Then, I think we want to anticipate now, because if we find a tune, we'll probably take it. We do have an Aether Hub, so we can play that if we miss. All right, yeah, we miss, so we'll take Fumigate, put those on the bottom, play Aether Hub. So now we're just one energy short. If we draw Aether Hub, that would be great. Oh, interesting. So they're a Saheeli deck that is also playing Heart of Kieran. That's unexpected. Alright, well, no such luck on drawing a way to make energy, but here's Aetherworks Marvel. Hopefully we don't die. Yeah, game one you don't have a ton of ways to interact with the combo, but unless you can get down Marvel. Took an Evolving Wilds and then played it. Obviously cracking it here because they're going to plus Saheeli. At least I assume they're going to plus Saheeli. Maybe they minus two on this Servant. No, they're plus one-ing. Okay. So we go to 18. If we draw a way to make energy, I think we're in really good shape. That qualifies, so let's go ahead and cast that bad boy. And then I think we just pass here. There's no real reason to act now. If we hit Harness Lightning or Fumigate, we can break up the combo if they have it. Otherwise, we can just end of turn, probably do something good, hopefully Ulamog. And we actually have access to enough energy to spin again if we don't hit Ulamog. So I think we should be in pretty good shape.
Huh.
Kind of odd to plus one Saheeli there. That means that they don't get to blink Oath of Nissa now if they go for it, which I would think is something they would be interested in. All right, well, we didn't exactly hit. Harness Lightning is actually a pretty bad hit because it requires us to spend an energy, but I guess we'll do it. Which actually now leaves us an energy short, so we need a thing that goes to the graveyard to re-trigger our Marvel. But yeah, they could have blinked Oath of Nissa as like a giant free roll if they had just not plussed, which I assume, yeah, draw a card is worth more than scry one and deal a damage to us. So we'll crack our puzzle knot. And hopefully draw another way to make energy. Nope. Drew the card that we would have preferred to Marvel into. Well, let's hope we don't die again and go ahead and get some stuff. Now we're just a land away from Ulamogging. Okay. I mean, that seems threatening, but again, if we get to cast Ulamog, it really doesn't matter. And we also have Fumigate, even if we brick, so we should be in okay shape. Puzzle Knot. All right, well, we'll jam that. And I kind of want to spin Marvel now, but again, there's no real reason to. We're at a plenty high life total. Yeah, I think we just pass again. Okay, looks like they probably kept that Oath of Nissa on top. And there's a Felidar Guardian. So this time they actually do have to blink Saheeli. But again, we want to wait for them to commit to minusing on the Felidar Guardian before we spin the Marvel. All right, so we could. I think we just fumigate here. We could take another Marvel and try to spin again, but we might as well just spin again on our turn and just cast this fumigate is fine. The funny part is we could have actually let them go off a little bit, and then we could really be immune to dying to regular damage, but there's obviously no way to know that we were going to hit fumigate, and if we hit Harness Lightning, it would be really bad to let them make a bunch of stuff. So we'll do that. And now I think we want to Marvel on our turn if we. Okay, well, I was going to say if we don't draw land, because we could have hit Attune with the Aether, and then we can cast Ulamog. But now we can just cast Ulamog, and that'll probably win us the game. So I think we want to just hit Saheeli and Plains, because then our opponent is at least two pieces away from comboing us again, which I think is by far the most likely way that we lose. All right. Well, that was a pretty easy game. We did have to Marvel twice, but we didn't even hit the best thing either time. So, sideboarding. I like Authority of the Consoles. I don't think Dynamolt Tower is very good. I think the Fumigates are good if our opponent is trying to win with like green Gear Hulks and stuff. Aether Meltdown seems kind of medium, but they do have those pesky Heart of Kirin's. Let's see, what else would we want to board out? Main deck's pretty tight. I guess I could see cutting one Meltdown. Sure. I don't think we really want all the negates. Again, if they're green gear hulking, it seems pretty easy to actually lose to that plan if we board out like too much of our good removal sort of stuff. I could see wanting to bring in Tracker maybe for like more Meltdowns or something, but I'm gonna be conservative and just leave our deck as is. Try not to board too much with our combo deck. All right, here we are for game two. We're on the draw. And sand looks good. Got a number of lands, a Marvel. basically everything you want. The only question is whether we turn one attune or turn two attune off of Canopy Vista. I think I'm inclined to just turn two it. I think our energy seems like it'll be pretty valuable this game, and I would rather preserve it if possible. Okay, so they attune for an island. Ooh, we drew an island. All right, so we can attune for, I guess, a mountain now. We have Harness Lighting in hand that we would prefer not to have to spend any energy to cast, so that sounds good. And there's the Saheeli. Okay, that's not a great draw. I should have played Island there. I forgot that I already had energy. That was a mistake. Okay, so they're going with an attune. That doesn't actually do all that much. Yeah, not playing the island might be kind of costly here. I still want to end up turn anticipate, I think. I think we just want the land. Or maybe we want... No, probably an additional Harness Lightning is good. I'm not too worried about our marble being countered, because we're not even going to cast the next turn. We're just going to glimmer. So I think it's fine to just load up on ways to interact with their combo. Okay. Rogue Refiner, no problemo. And it looks like they probably don't have Negate, because I think they would have tapped differently. Well, maybe not. I guess they only have one blue source, so maybe they do have Negate still. Yeah. Well, that's okay. We didn't need that one so badly. All right, well, we might as well play this while they're tapped out. I guess we just pass. We could Harness Lightning the Rogue Refiner right now. I think we are ultimately going to have to do that. Yeah, well, if they play Green Gear Hulk, I guess it would be better to not have done that. So I won't. They also might minus the Healy on it, but that seems unlikely. I assume that with the Green Gear Hulk in my opponent's deck, they actually have good stuff to get with Saheeli. Maybe not quite enough to just win the game on the spot, but actually pretty good stuff, probably. Tamiyo, sure. Well, now we're definitely killing that Rogue Refiner. Okay, we net an energy off that. Not too bad. And Servant of the Conduit doesn't really do anything. So now we can feel pretty safe to go ahead and jam that marble. And we can Harness Lightning with no effect to trigger it if we need to. All right, so they still don't want to Saheeli us, so they probably don't have, like, a red Gear Hulk and a green Gear Hulk or something like that. They probably only have green Gear Hulk to get, which is not, I mean, it would be good, but it's not that scary. We are ultimately going to have to kill that Servant. Oh, okay, so they have Shatters in their sideboard. I guess that's reasonable. Okay. What did they blink here? Probably. Sure, just Aether Hub. Alright. Well, I suppose I would cast Fumigate if I drew another land. I think we'll just anticipate and try to find a land. And I guess Aether Hub is as good as any. And then we can harness lightning down the servant. I think we'll just do that now. And then next turn we can Aether Melt down the Felidar Guardian. They are probably going to get to Ultimate Tamiyo, but that is also not an auto win. It's going to be good, but Fumigate can cure a lot of problems like that. Oh, right, they have Heart of Kieran in their deck. We knew that. Wait, but they boarded out the green Gearhulk or something? That's very interesting. They just got Heart of Kieran. Alright, well, I guess we just go ahead and Fumigate. They do get to bash us with Heart, but that's not the end of the world. They don't get to... It's hard for them to draw cards with Tamiyo in this spot. Okay, so they're just going to continue to draw cards with Tamiyo. Well, we do have Aether Meltdown to stop that next turn. Servant of the Conduit is in there. And another Saheeli. I don't quite get that. I don't really understand the allure of playing the other Saheeli there. So we could just go... I think we just go land, go, and then Glimmer plus Aether Meltdown. Sounds pretty appealing. All right, there's the Tamiyo ult. I guess maybe I should have responded to the Tamiyo ult with the Glimmer. Here comes the Goon Squad. We'll go ahead and try to melt down the Heart. I actually don't care that much if Meltdown resolves now. If they're not drawing a card off Heart, it's not even that big a deal. Because we're just going to Glimmer and then play Puzzle Knot on our turn, probably. Or Nissa's Renewal. Like, we just have a ton of life gain. So I'd actually rather them be forced to use Negate on Aether Meltdown as opposed to on something actually good. Like, I'd much rather resolve Glimmer than Aether Meltdown, I think. Okay. Whirler Virtuoso gains us a bit of life, and we'll go ahead and Glimmer. They might have another Negate. No, I guess not. Fumigate and Glimmer. Both pretty appealing. We could just keep both, cast Fumigate, gain some more life. I think we probably actually just want to bottom this Fumigate, though. Because then we have a turn of Glimmer plus Puzzle Knot, which seems really good. So I think we just, play, well, let's see. We maybe have to, maybe we want to harness Lightning the Heart and play Glimmer. Maybe that's better. It's probably better. Yeah, I think we'll plan to do that. Our opponent also has a whole bunch of energy, but their Thopters don't actually deal damage to us this turn, sort in a way, because we have authority of the consoles. So like they have to have the, they have to get have them around for two turns before they really do anything. Alright, so they're making the smart play of plussing on the Thopters, which I still have to kill Heart because it deals the most damage and also survives Fumigate. And then we might as well Glimmer now before they get access to a bunch more cards. Don't want either of those. Don't really want either of these either, but we can gain a bunch of life at least. Oh, they just have another Saheeli to kill us. All right. Well, yeah, we didn't do a lot that game. Didn't really have a lot going on. Tideless Tracker seems like it would have actually been pretty good. Meltdown is not bad because of the Heart, but I think Tracker is going to be better. So I'm going to make that swap, particularly on the play. Heart is just a lot less worrisome. And maybe board out one Fumigate as well. Okay, yeah, let's give this a try. Alright, here we are for game three. We get to go first. This hand is mediocre, but I think it might be a keep because of Tracker. It's got a plan at least. No, this is probably a mulligan. Well, this hand is also awful. This hand is truly horrible as well. Well, I wish I'd kept the first one now, but I think it was a mulligan because it had two cards that don't do anything until turn 9 against an opponent who has a fairly proactive game plan. Obviously, if I had known that our 6 was going to be 6 lands and our 5 was going to be 2 of the same legend and 10 drop, I would have not mulliganed that hand. But that's not the world we live in. Okay, yeah, Rogue Refiner's pretty good. I guess we just kill the Rogue Refiner and hope that we can keep him off Heart of Kieran for a little while at least. If we draw a green source, we could get right back in this. If we just played Tracker that turn, I would not feel too awful, but yeah. Probably not to be. It's too bad. That game two seemed pretty winnable. I wonder if we could have played more conservatively and won. Not getting our heart or getting our marble shattered. Although Shatter is kind of an unusual card because this deck, our opponent's deck actually cares about things like Authority of the Consoles. So I would think they would go with the cheaper option. I did not expect them to have Shatter. Alright, well if we just runner lands now, maybe we can get back in things. If we draw a green source into untapped land and then just marvel into Ulamog, might be good enough. Might also not, who knows. Here comes Saheeli, so they can minus on Rogue Refiner. Heart, yeah, we're not going to win the race now. Even if we draw a green source exactly. We're going to take 7 this turn, and then next turn they can actually attack for 10, which kills us through a Woodweaver's Puzzledon activation. Well, kind of an anticlimactic game three. I guess they might not go for the kill. That would be pretty weird, but yeah, weird things happen in Magic all the time. So yeah, they can mine a Saheeli on Rogue Refiner, then use Saheeli's last loyalty to Crew Heart, or just, you know, play a creature or Planeswalker. Then they don't even have to use up their Saheeli completely. All right, yeah, that's plenty. They got us beat in many different ways. All right, we'll be back for round two.